Welcome to Dr. Piercy's Downloading and Installing Eclipse. This video was made under a Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial License. In this video, you're going to learn what Eclipse is and what it can be used for. You'll see how to download and install Eclipse, and we'll take a brief look at Eclipse to see that it is working on your computer. So you may be asking, what is Eclipse? Eclipse is a development environment, a software application with lots of tools that you can use to create stuff. Eclipse is integrated. This means that all the tools provided by Eclipse are collected in one software package that works together. You can also think of integrated as meaning diverse components that you create are integrated to form a complete project. So finally, Eclipse is known as an Integrated Development Environment, or IDE. Eclipse is provided by the Eclipse Foundation. You can find its website at www.eclipse.org. To get started with the Eclipse software, click on the download button that you'll see at the upper right corner of the Eclipse webpage. This will take you to a page that has a list of various versions of Eclipse. These versions start with the standard version of Eclipse, but then they add or take away various modules depending on what you want to do with them. For web development, we're going to want to use the Eclipse IDE for Java EE developers. You'll find that just under the black bar marked Package Solutions. This is the one that will let us build web components such as servlets and JSPs. Near the side of the box for the Eclipse IDE, you'll notice a couple links for downloading different versions of that particular IDE. You should see that it's already recognized your particular operating system. For instance, on mine, it shows that I have a Mac. We also see we have a 32-bit and a 64-bit. Another thing you should note is that you will need the Java runtime environment. If you do not already have that, you'll need to download that first. I'm going to right-click on Java runtime environment to show you how you might get that. This will take me to a wiki page that gives me several links that I can use to get to the Java JDK. Since Oracle is the owner of Java currently, I am going to click on the Oracle JDK link. Looks like it's Java version 8. I'm going to click Download for JDK. Here I'll see a list of various versions depending on the operating system. I'm going to pick the Mac OS X64. It's important to note that we're getting the 64-bit version because when we get our Eclipse version, we need to get the one that matches. Note if you click on it too soon, it'll tell you you need to accept the license agreement first. So, accept the license agreement. I've already looked it over a few times, so I'm not going to bother reading it, but if you feel like you need to, there's a link to go read the license agreement. Once you've done that, you can then choose your version. For Mac, pick the OS X64. For Windows, you need to either get the X64 or the X86. X86 is the 32-bit version. I'd go with the 64-bit version if you have Windows 7 or later. So click on the link corresponding to your operating system and your desired bit size. On the Mac, Finder will come up asking me where I want to put it. In general, I'm going to store this one to downloads. This may take a bit of time to download. It's 209 megabits, so I'll be back after it completes the download. So my download is completed. I need to install the JDK, so I'm going to click on the downloaded DMG file. It tells me I can double-click on the icon to install. Now I see the installer window. I just click through the install and follow the instructions to complete the installation of the JDK. Now I can click Close and my JDK should be installed. Once the JDK is installed, it should then be okay to download and install the Eclipse IDE. Recall that I got the 64-bit JDK, so I need to make sure that I choose the 64-bit Eclipse IDE for Java EE developers that works on my operating system. So I'm going to click on Mac OS X 64-bit. There should be one or more links where you can do this download and you can select from. I generally pick the top one, so I'll click on that one. It will ask me where. I'll put it just simply in downloads for now. This may take a while, so I'm going to skip ahead until after it's already been downloaded to complete the installation. Okay, so the file has downloaded for me. I'm going to have a look at it in the downloads folder on my computer. And I see I have Eclipse, JEE, Luna, R, Mac OS X, Cocoa, x86, 64.tar.gz. The .tar.gz basically means it's a type of file compression. On a Mac, I can simply click on this and it will decompress the file. On Windows, you might have to right-click and choose the decompression option. What you should see now is that I now have within my downloads folder, which is currently a mess, the Eclipse folder. I like to stay a little bit organized, so I'm actually going to move the Eclipse folder to my Applications folder. Let me grab a new file window real quick, open up the Applications folder, and I'm going to drag Eclipse over there. I can close my Downloads folder. Inside the Applications folder, I can now see that I have the Eclipse folder. Eclipse is not a software that you actually need to install. You simply need to click on the executable file to run it. So I've cleaned up the screen a little bit, and I see that the Eclipse folder is currently in my Applications folder. If I open it, I see the different files that were downloaded. You should notice one file, the actual application file, with an icon beside it, and it says Eclipse, uppercase on my machine. Eclipse is not a software that I need to install. I simply need to click on the executable anytime I want to run that. I could keep it here, but a nice thing to do is to add it either to your desktop or to your dock, depending on your system. So I'm going to grab mine. I'm clicking and holding, and I'm going to drag it down to my dock. Let's see, where do I want to put it? Let's put it right there. Now we see on my dock my Eclipse icon. So if I simply click on the Eclipse icon, since this is the first time, it's going to ask me if I want to open it for sure. Then I will. And we'll start to see Eclipse load. When Eclipse loads, you get the Workspace Launcher. The Workspace is a place on your hard drive where your Eclipse projects will be stored by default. You get a chance to select where that will be. I usually take the default selection, which is a folder that is going to be called Workspace, lowercase w, on my hard drive. I can choose where to put that, but you can see that mine is going to be in Users, Craig Piercy, Documents, Workspace. Be sure to note where yours is going to be, or make your own selection using the Browse or typing in the window. I don't like to see this all the time, so I'm going to click Use this as the default and Do not ask again. There's a way in Eclipse you can change this if you should change your mind in the future. Click OK. And here we see the Eclipse IDE with the welcome page open. This may or may not come up the first time you load Eclipse. This is a nice place to go if you want to search on the web for tutorials and other types of resources that you can use to learn how to use Eclipse. If you don't want to see the welcome window, just click on the X for the tab. And now we see the Eclipse IDE. Look for a later video that will give you a brief tour of the components of the Eclipse IDE. For now, I know that it's working, so I'm going to end this video. The primary reference for this video and the content found here is the Eclipse Foundation website at eclipse.org. This is your go-to source for all things concerning Eclipse. If you want to know about Eclipse, or need some help, or to look at documentation, this is where you should start. This video was written, narrated, and produced by Dr. Craig A. Piercy. Background music is DC 3000 by Thievery Corporation from the Wired CD RIP Sample Mass Share 2004. This has been a Piercy production.